Allegations of misconduct published in the Israeli daily Haaretz from the mouths of Israeli soldiers who served during the Gaza incursion. One described an army commander ordering unarmed civilians, quote, taken out for no specific reason. Another story describes a woman and her two children being shot because they took the wrong path. Just two accusations that made headlines in Israel and around the Arab world. Israel Defense Forces Chief Gabi Ashkenazi categorically denied that soldiers harmed Palestinians in cold blood. The response from the Israeli press varied. In Yediot Ahronot, accounts from other soldiers rebutting the claims and describing the army actions as honorable. This commentator saying, quote, it's time to believe the allegations. Still, others, such as Israeli human rights groups, calling for an investigation. Hirsch Goodman is an Israeli military affairs analyst.
If soldiers misbehave as per the news, newspaper articles, you put them on trial.
Defending Israel's image is the topic this Israeli Channel 2 newscast highlights as it explores the effects the alleged crimes story has in Britain and Europe. It also provides the Israeli army's reaction, accusing Hamas of using civilians as human shields and even booby-trapping schools, mosques and homes. For Arab media, this is a case of we told you so. Complaints of major human rights abuses during the Gaza offensive were an integral part of reporting the story for Arab networks. Among the latest, this official from the international organization Human Rights Watch speaking on Al Jazeera about what his group claims is Israel's use of phosphorus in crowded areas. The Israeli army says it will investigate, but says it only used phosphorus as a smokescreen, not a weapon. And then there's this political cartoon from the London-based Ash-Sharq al-Awsat, providing a glimpse into Arab media coverage. The testimony of Israeli soldiers, it suggests, will prove most harmful to Israel. Octavia Nasser, CNN, reporting.